We see the hand of God in the light of creation's grand design, in the lives of those who prove His faithfulness, who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning and welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. Hey man, thanks for joining us this morning. We're so delighted you're here. I know I am, and I know our church is as well. As we get going, we continue in our reading of the book of Philippians, an epistle, a letter from Paul to Philippi, to the Christians in Philippi, a letter full of joy. Paul has said, we saw yesterday, that he is confident that God's going to complete the good work that he began in them. He is confident that he'll do it at the day of Christ Jesus, and he is thankful for each one of them and their partnership with him for the gospel. Now, we pick this up in verse 7 of Philippians chapter 1. It is right for me to feel this way about all of you, since I have you in my heart, and whether I am in chains and or defending and confirming the gospel, all of you share in God's grace with me. God can testify how I long for you, all of you, with the affection of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in knowledge and depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God. Now, Paul here says, it is right for me to feel confident about what God is doing for you. It is right for me to love you and appreciate you and to be thankful for you in my prayers. It's right for me to feel this affection toward you, since I have you in my heart, and whether I am in chains or defending and confirming the gospel, we all share in God's grace together. You know, that's the thing that's beautiful about the Christian church and the body of Christians, whether it be your local congregation or whether it be the church at large. We share in the grace of God. We share in the specific saving grace of our God and Savior. It is ours, given to us by Christ, received through faith as the work of the Holy Spirit. And so as we come before the Lord and we come before each other and we come to each other, we recognize that we share in the grace of God. We share in the same grace that the Apostle Paul shared in. We share in the same grace that the church in Philippi shared in. And Paul says, it's right for me to feel this affection toward you because we're of sharers of the same grace, partakers of the same grace, made alive by the same Spirit. And so he says, this is how I feel about each one of you, and I can long for you, and I long to spend time with you with the affection of Christ Jesus. I love you in the way Christ loves you. I want to spend time with you. I want to be around you. We should want to be around the believers. We should want to be around the brothers and the sisters, not neglecting it. So many of us have taken the opportunity in recent years to neglect the gathering of the brothers, to neglect the time spent with the sisters, because we have said we've got access to God in various different capacities through the digital media world. But the reality of it is that we miss that fellowship. We miss that affection. And Paul says, I'm in prison. I'm kept from you, and I long to be with you. I long to be in your presence. I long to be encouraged by you. I long to be strengthened by you. I mean, you got to remember, this church was founded by the Apostle Paul after some miraculous events. He had Lydia, the tent maker. Paul lived with and worked with her and her family. And then you had the Philippian jailer episode in Acts chapter 16. This is the first really significant work of God's grace through Paul in the land of Macedonia after receiving the Macedonian call to go into the Macedonian world to proclaim the good news of Christ. And so there's a tremendous amount of affection here between Paul and the Philippians, and he longs to be with them, and he can't. Absence makes the heart grow fonder, they say. And they said, this is my prayer, that you may that your love may abound more and more in the knowledge and depth of insight, that you may abound in love more and more in the knowledge and the depth of insight. Love is taking on an intellectual nature in that statement. Paul's praying, I pray that you grow in your knowledge of God, that you will be able to discern what is best and pure and be blameless for the day of Christ, that you'll learn and understand what you are confronting in this world and how is the best way to go about applying the Word of God to your life. And then I want you to be filled with the fruit of righteousness. I want that application of the wisdom to actually bear fruit in your life. And I want that righteousness to come through the Lord Jesus Christ, who is the one who gives it to you, to the glory and praise of God. I want you to live a life that is bringing glory to God. And that's the challenge for each one of us. That's what Paul wanted for the Philippians. That's what God wants from us. It's what God wanted from the Philippians. It's what God wants from us. And so keep that in mind. We need to be praying for each other and be thankful that God has revealed to us that he wants our love to grow more, abound more and more in the knowledge and depth of insight, that we'll be able to apply the truth of God to the way we live our lives and be blameless for the day of Christ and bearing fruit of righteousness, a righteousness that comes to us through Jesus as a result of the gift of his grace, all for the glory and praise of God. Hey, guys, I hope that is encouraging. I hope it also challenges you to live a life of righteousness, to bear fruit, and where you're growing more and more in the knowledge of God. Take care. God bless you. I'll see you Monday.